Hi, thank you for stopping by. In this video today, we're going to be looking at the ECFMG certification. For IMGs wanting to start work in the United States, the process of ECFMG certification is very confusing. So today, we're here to help to explain a little bit about it, what the pathways are, and what that entails for you in your journey to the United States. My name is Mark Higney. I have been involved with education for about 20 years. The past 10 years, I've been working with international medical graduates. If you're an international medical graduate and you're struggling on how to start, you don't know anyone, I want to provide that information and material for you so you can get to the United States. I have worked at Brigham and Women's and Massachusetts General Hospital, helping doctors improve their English communication skills. On this channel, we do have English communication skills videos, as well as informative videos such as today's one on the ECFMG. If you enjoyed this content, please consider liking this video and subscribing to this channel. Don't forget to put the notifications on so you get updated when we update the content. If you're interested in learning more, let's take a look at ECFMG certification. We will look at the ECFMG and why it is important. We'll talk about the World Directory of Medical Schools a bit and introduce you to the application portal. An important point will be going over what you need before applying. The remaining portion today will be explaining the six pathways IMGs can use to get certified by the ECFMG. Additional Commission for Foreign Medical Graduates, ECFMG, was formed in 1956. The purpose is to evaluate medical professionals from outside the US and Canada. They check and verify an applicant's CV, USMLE scores, medical school diploma, and courses. Hospitals and institutions have access to ECFMG databases to hire and train international medical graduates, IMGs. If you want to work in the US in a hospital, you will need to have ECFMG certification. It is required by most licensing authorities in the US, which includes states and specialty boards. In order to practice medicine, you will need to have passed the USMLE Step 3 exam. In order to take it, you need the ECFMG certification. It is necessary for everyone who has a medical education outside of the US and Canada. This means an American studying in the UK has to apply for this, even though he or she is a US citizen. Medical schools list schools that are considered to have high standards of education and training. The list is very extensive, covering every country in the world. If the school is not listed, the graduates may not be eligible for work in the US. Just a note is that other countries may use this criteria as well. At this time, Canada and the EU also use this list. The portal is quite easy to follow. It does require notarization, which can be done through the portal. This portal will connect to all services you will use in your journey, including USMLE score reporting, uploading documents, and applying for residency programs in the US. The ECFMG connects to the Electronic Residency Application Service, ERAS, which is used for residency. As noted, the fee is $160. As stated, you will need to fill out the application and can be notarized through the program. You will need to have passed the United States Medical Licensing Exam, Step 1 and Step 2 Clinical Knowledge. As the Step 2 CS is no longer used, you will need to pass the Occupational English Test, OET, Medicine before applying. If you are in medical school and have done all these steps, you can begin applying as well. The application process can take time, and there is no general turnaround time for this. Pathway 1 is for licensed practicing doctors. Pathway 2 is for medical graduates who have passed an OSCE in their home country. Pathways 3, 4, and 5 are for specific medical school graduates. Pathway 6 is for anyone who does not meet Pathways 1 to 5. The mini CEX is an evaluating exam. If you have graduated from an approved accredited medical school, have been licensed in your country, you can apply through Pathway 1.
must be licensed without supervision, and it must be after January 2018. This is a license to practice medicine. If you're currently working as a doctor, this should not be a problem for you. Pathway 2 is for medical graduates who have had an OSCE or Objective Structured Clinical Examination while in school. This refers to a series of mock patient encounters that are evaluated objectively by the school. In 2016, around 133 schools in the US had such an exam for students to graduate. Pathway 3 is another way for students and graduates of select medical schools to work in the US. It is based in the UK and works much like the World Directory of Medical Schools. Medical schools verified by the World Federation for Medical Education have access to ECFMG's databank. If a medical school is not recognized by the WFME or the WDMS, the school can apply for recognition by the US government. The educational quality will be evaluated accordingly and is handled through the Department of Education. At this time, many schools are in the UK, Poland, and the Czech Republic. Pathway 5 is a joint venture program. A US medical school can partner with a foreign medical school and offer the same degree. While the students are getting a US-based education, it is not the same as graduating from medical school in the US. As of this video, there are only two programs, Duke University and the National University of Singapore, and Weill Cornell Medical College in Qatar. Pathway 6 is the last pathway, and it is for any medical school student or graduate that cannot go through the previous pathways. A mini clinical evaluation exercise is a 10 to 15 minute clinical encounter showing that the test taker has the skills to be a doctor in the US. This is called the mini clinical evaluation exercise, or CEX. The exam is evaluated by an approved doctor who must fill out a secure assessment form through the ECFMG site. I know this is a lot of information for you. It is important to know how to start. First off, you can begin studying for the USMLE Steps 1 and 2 CK. Those are required. If possible, try to boost your English skills by speaking and engaging in English. If you have a chance, try to practice clinical encounters with English-speaking friends to give you experience. Ask fellow doctors and attendings about what you can do if they have any contacts. Lastly, contact English for Doctors. We've been helping IMGs for nearly 10 years getting ready for life and work in the US.
Thank you for watching this video today. I know it might seem a lot to you. I know it may be very confusing and a little bit overwhelming, but we're here to help. If you do have any comments, please feel free to leave us a comment. If you enjoy this content, please consider subscribing and liking this channel. Please don't forget to turn on notifications so you get updated when we post new content. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time, have a great one.